The United Arab Emirates is a relatively small nation, but is stepping into a large domain, that is, making itself a nuclear power. The UAE economy is an international business center and relies on its natural gas and petroleum remunerations. UAE is now building its nuclear plant, Barakah Nuclear Power Plant, to decrease its dependency on the oil that has been powering it and its neighbors for a long time. Abu Dhabi Crown Prince Muhammad bin Zayed al-Nahyan called it a historic milestone for UAE. If you want to know the exciting details of this power plant, keep on watching the video. Barakah Nuclear Power Plant. Barakah plant is located at Al-Dafra of the Emirate of Abu Dhabi on the Arabian Gulf, the coastline between the Persian Gulf and the E11 highway, at a distance of 53 kilometers from the city of Ruwais. This 5,600 megawatt power plant, situated in Abu Dhabi, is the first project of its kind in the whole United Arab Emirates. It also has the accolade of being the second power plant in the Persian Gulf. A grand ceremony to celebrate this mega project was held in March 2011. Contracting. Emirates Nuclear Energy Corporation granted a collaboration led by Korea Electric Power Corporation a $20 billion proposal to build the power plant in UAE. Four APR 1400 nuclear units were planned to be built at Barakah, with the first atomic reactor to activate the electricity supply by 2017. As per reports by Bloomberg in 2011, the construction costs were $30 billion and sponsored with $10 billion in equity, $10 billion in export credit agency debt, and $10 billion from the bank and sovereign obligation. South Korea was reported to attain a further $20 billion from the operation, upkeeping, and fuel supply agreements. This was later increased to $25 billion. The project's total cost was finally raised to $24.4 billion by March 2018. Construction. This $13 billion plant is a joint venture by Emirates Nuclear Energy Corporation, ENEC, and Korea Electric Power Corporation, KEPCO, called Nawa Energy Company. It will include four units of 1,400 megawatts each. KEPCO was handed over this project after a year-long evaluation by a 75-member delegation of international professionals. Several facets were accessed, including safety measures, commercial offers, the command to deliver excellence, and a commitment to human resource development. The contract included the installation and commissioning of four APR 1400 nuclear reactor units. The APR 1400 technology is based on System 80+, authorized by the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission, NRC. It took them 10 years to develop the final design. Construction of the first unit started in July 2012. It was followed by the receipt of a construction license by the Federal Authority of Nuclear Regulations, FANR, along with a no-objection certificate from the Environmental Agency Abu Dhabi, EAD, which is the environment regulating body. This shows that the planned layout satisfied the standards of three national regulatory bodies, including the NRC, which has experience of over 60 years in monitoring and handling the nuclear industry. The plant was planned to be opened in 2017, but it got delayed due to some safety requirements. Construction was concluded by the end of May 2018. A quick reminder, before we further continue our discussion on this topic, if you've enjoyed the video so far, consider subscribing, as we frequently upload such information and educational videos. Let's continue. Units of Barakah Power Plant. Barakah Plant has four nuclear reactors that will supply up to 25% of the UAE's electricity once all four get functional. The first concrete was coursed for Unit 3 in September 2014, while construction of Unit 4 began in September 2015. 2014 saw the deliverance of first reactor vessel at Barakah, and site preparation started for Units 3 and 4. The concrete and steel containment building for Unit 1 was finalized by January 2015. In March of the same year, Emirates Nuclear Energy Corporation applied to Federal Authority for Nuclear Regulation for operating licenses for first two nuclear reactors. In September of 2015, the same year, the first concrete was streamed for Unit 4. At this time, more than 180,000 professionals were working on all the reactors collectively. A few voids were found in the concrete containment buildings for Unit 2 and 3 in December 2018. It was reported that grease had leaked through Unit 3 containment, which could be a consequence of a crack in the concrete. First unit was proclaimed complete in 2018, but the operators were not planned to start until late 2019 or the beginning of 2020. Fuel loading was announced to be commenced in January 2020, which is almost 2.5 years later than the initially planned date of August 2017. almost 400 adverse findings were interrogated in an inspection, requiring correction of several technical, organizational, and management issues by Fanner. The first commercial unit received its operating license in 2020 from the nuclear regulator, 3 years after its plant startup in 2017. Fuel assembly loading of the first unit by the plant was completed in March 2020, leading to the commencement of nuclear operations. In 2021, Unit 1 was linked to the national grid, and in December, it reached its maximum capacity during testing. Construction of Unit 2 commenced in August 2021. In March 2022, it received its operating license. Unit 3 is also complete, with its operations expected to begin in late 2022. Unit 4 is 89% towards completion as of April 2021. As of November 2021, the construction culmination rate is about 96%. Barakah adopts endurable energy sources. Thus, UAE has strategic plans to make this power plant meet a quarter of its energy requirement. Once fully functional, the Barakah plant is anticipated to prevent about 22 million tons of carbon emissions yearly, equal to 4.8 million road cars. Concerns and criticism. The world has been questioning the construction of the Barakah power plant, calling it a threat to the stability and environment of the territory. They believe UAE has plans to use it against its rivals. At the same time, UAE insists that the purpose of this nuclear plan is to just produce energy. Qatar, a rival of the United Arab Emirates and Saudi Arabia, has lodged a complaint to International Atomic Energy Agency against the Barakah plant, calling it a flagrant threat to regional peace and environment. The International Nuclear Consulting Group also highlighted the risk of radioactive pollution. Emirates Nuclear Energy Corporation dismissed the allegations and claimed its working practices were safe and secure. The motive of this nuclear plant is to diversify its energy conceptions and provide pure and efficient energy to all of the UAE grid while decarbonizing the economy. Federal Authority for Nuclear Regulation is the regulatory body that inspects all the elements and ensures the work environment is safe for its workers. The safety concerns were protection against accidental radiation, automatic shutting off of the system if and when required, and emergency response plans. The Barakah power plant is strong enough to defy the blow of an aircraft crash. This project is an example of the advancement UAE is making in technology. It is not only significant for the economy of the United Arab Emirates, but might be an excellent recruitment option for many youths to be involved in the industry. Share your thoughts with us in the comments section. If you learned something new today, make sure to like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to Made Wealth Finder so that we can keep making such fantastic videos for you. Thanks for watching.